four to negative seven, negative 28. So that went in there as just a throwback to old school, easy, I would say, factoring.
Yep.
Okay. Easier than this is. Let's take this one. I'm gonna run out of room. Right there. Okay. Then we do that x thing. Okay. 4 times 15 is 60. So we need two numbers that multiply to 60 and add to 16. I was surprised as I walked around, you know, I made sure to say both times we worked on those homework problems, is 6 and 10, what's important about them, what are we using them for? We found these two numbers because they do two special things. They multiply to 60, which is the same as what 4 and 15 multiply to, and they add to 16. It's important that they add to 16 because we're going to write 16n as 10n plus 6n. Right? I add those together to get 16n, but I want it to be 10n and 6n.
Yeah.
The reason why 10 and 6 are so special is because, again, they multiply to 60, which is the same thing that 4 times 15 is. Right? This is 60, and 10 times 6 is 60, which tells me that these are going to have to share some factors. And these are going to have to share some factors, because all these guys are factors of 60. Which sets up the next step. We want them to have common factors, because we want to factor out those common factors. So we look at these as two groups. Here's one. I like to call it the yellow group.
You could leave that one blank.
No way. Okay, so the yellow one. Those two have in common?
2n.
2n, that's the largest factor that you can pull out of both is 2n, leaving us with?
2n plus 5.
2n plus 5, what do these two have in common?
3.
Yeah.
3 times 2n plus 5.
Yes.
I guess we should have at least that.
Then you got your...
I'm going to, because people are not understanding what the last step, like what it's supposed to look like, and I will never ever just tell you, we'll just write these things and those things there, because it's just, I can't do it morally. All right? So let me show you exactly what's going on. It's not a crazy thing. Each of these two terms has a 2n plus 5, and we're going to factor it out. All that sounded like maybe gibberish, so let me... explain further. Let me just start by writing my final answer. I'm going to factor out the 2n minus 5 for both of those. That's going to give me a 2n plus 5 factor. Okay, let's multiply by the leftovers there. We're left over with a 2n when we divide out the 2n plus 5 factor from this term here. And we're left with this 3 when we divide out the 2n plus 5. Just like left with the 2n. Here, when we divide 2n, we're left with 5 when you divide just by 2n. You're left with 2n when you divide away, it's 2n plus 5. And you're left with 3 when you divide away, it's 2n plus 5.
All right. I don't understand that.
Can I
once
draw,
again,
like, just, can I add a couple sticks in there that I think that would help
all right.
those that are confused?
Throw a couple sticks in there and
yeah.
see where that gets us.
Okay.
Where I can show you. All right.
Maybe it's for you now. Okay, so literally, just all you do is that these guys are the same here. So
okay.
you just take one of those,
okay.
and that's half the thing.
Mm-hmm.
And then the next one is just this and this. That's it.
Okay.
Well, that's wrong. But
that's what I do every time. I get it right.
This is what I say over and over. Like, if you do that, yes, right answer every time. Can't stop you from doing that. Okay. But still not correct. I'm not just taking one of these and putting it there and disappearing the other one.
No, it's the same thing. It's like the same thing that's been multiplied. It's just double distributed backwards.
Yes.
You just take one of the ones that you see, because it is the same, right?
Right.
And that's one of your parentheses. That's all I was saying. I'm not getting rid of it entirely or forgetting it.
But you could understand how someone who sees who sees all that could not, like, could be ignoring the math, even though you're thinking about the math. And you just draw an arrow from here to there, and then, like, you wonder, like, well, what about, like, should I draw an arrow from there to there?
No. I'm talking about the leftover from what's already not in the parentheses is a whole parenthesis itself.
Right.
That's double distribution backwards.
Yeah.
That's what I've been saying.
It is double distribution backwards. It's exactly what I want everybody to understand, but with these just arrows like that going there, that there, and that there.
But if it's always the right answer, if she does it that way, then why can't we do it?
I can't stop you from doing it, but that's not my explanation, because it's like saying, God is magic. I'll never tell you math because magic.
I gave you an explanation for
your explanation. I love it. It's absolutely sound. But what a lot of people want to do is just say, okay, so that's one of the parentheses, and the other parentheses is just 2n plus 3. But you don't have to know anything about double distribution in reverse to write this.
I didn't say that.
That's not what you said, but that's what, like, if there was no audio there, if there was no you explaining it, it looks like put that there and put those two there.
Well, that's what it looks like to me.
Right. That's what you said.
Because is that what you do, though? Like,
no.
To make it right?
Okay. So, you can tell what's in the parentheses is going to be one of the parentheses itself, because it's the same. And when you use double distribution, you take one of both elements of the other parentheses and multiply it by the other. And that's what's happening. So we're just taking one of those, because we know that what is in both of those parentheses are the same. We just take those, that's one itself, and then what is distributed is another parentheses.
Right. I get that.
Okay.
Do you get that confused?
Yeah,
that
was
fun.
Okay, I also, like I said earlier, I know that it's difficult to listen to someone explain all the math behind it, when ultimately, what you said was what the arrows say.
Just helping them gesture what I was saying.
I know.
Very showy.
So,
very welcome.
So I'm going to take this. I'm going to do show you. Because, like, what we're learning today, we really need to be able to still do this. It's more of this. It's factoring, but then we're going to use factoring to solve. The good news is, like, all we really are doing is taking some of what we've learned recently, also some of what we did in section 9.4, just a couple sections ago, putting it all together. Okay, like, 9.4 kind of set us up without, like, they did some of the work for us, and then we solved the equation, and now we're able to do all of it. We can do the whole, everything, do it from beginning to end. So, we don't feel like doing it. I don't want you to feel like I'm wasting your time, but it's math class, and I want to try and help you see what Shelby sees, okay? Really, what she's really talking about, okay? I'm just gonna flip it around. Because in math, like, one way you can be sure you did whatever you're trying to do correctly is you just work the steps in reverse. So we're just gonna look at the steps in reverse. So if you can reverse these reversed steps, then you should be good to go. If I were given the task of multiplying these two parentheses together, I'll use double distribution and show you why all this is all the same as each other. That double distribution approach looks like this. Let me know about distribution. If there's something multiplied by parentheses, just multiply it by both of the things in the parentheses, right? Just as a quick aside, 3 times 4x plus 1 is 12x plus 3, right? Because I just distributed the 3. 3 times 4x is 12x, 3 times 1 is 3. We're all familiar with that. We've been doing it today already. We've been distributing things. The thing I'm trying to help you see is that this is also just as simple as that. We're distributing. But what are we distributing? Not just the number 3, But
half of the parentheses.
That entire left parentheses is about to get distributed. Distribute it. Just like I distribute the 3 to the 4x and the 1 negative 2 plus 3, I'm distributing the 2n plus 5. 2n plus 5 gets distributed to the 2n. 2n times 2n plus 5. 2n plus 5 gets distributed to the 3. 3 times 2n plus 5. Just those two guys each get their own 2n plus 5. And from here to there, from this step to the last step, we're just distributing the 2n. 2n times 2n is 4n squared. 2n times 5 is 10n. 3 times 2n is 6n. And 3 times 5 is 15. We add it all together, we get 4n squared is 16n plus 15. Looking at that way, did that make sense?
Yes.
Okay, that's like half of it. We're distributing the 2n plus 5 to the 2n and to the 3. Boom, boom. The 8 gets a 2n plus 3. And then we multiply it out further. That's double distribution. And what we are learning to do is double distribution in reverse. Okay? We're starting here. This is where we start when we're doing it in reverse. Each group gets its own greatest common factor factored out. In this case, the 2n gets factored out. In this case, the 3 gets factored out. And then we do more factoring out. We factor out the 2n plus 5 and the 2n plus 5 for both of those. And there it is. We factor it out for both. Okay. When I flip back here, and we see exactly the same writing, just in reverse steps, we're just reversing double distribution. Reversing double distribution is all.
Question.
Wyatt, question.
What happens if you have the little thing and then it says equal 0 to them?
Right. That's what happens when you jump ahead without waiting.
You should be probably just not waiting.
Just
this.
Okay. So. So once again, while Shelby is trying to explain that it's double distribution in reverse, and I'm very much like to doing that. Also, it looks like take that guy, put it there, and put those guys over there in another parentheses. Yes, that's going to be correct. So I'm done with all that. I'm trying to not beat this dead horse in front of you for too long.
I'm traumatized.
All right. So hopefully that's that. If you're still having trouble factoring like that, then just raise your hand and I'll write over and we'll figure it out together. But now we're going to solve equations where, this is part of that big old equation. Okay, so let's set it up as easy as we can set it up. And keep in mind, we've done this before, like in 9.4. We've done this already. The only thing is, 9.4 would have looked like this. It would have started here and just said, all this equals 0. It would have started from right there.
So
I got it.
Way.
You just ignore the 0 until you get to the 2 parentheses.
So what I'm getting out of this is this.
Yeah.
Takes more work.
So we factor first.
Yeah.
Don't really worry about the other side yet. And then work at 9.4. If saying 9.4, is, we did this in 9.4, it doesn't really bring a lot of comfort to you. Don't worry. We're going to talk about it. But the first part of it, solving this equation like this, like Shelby said, we just got to ignore the 0, don't worry about it. We have to factor it first in order for this to even work. Okay. And in 9.5, we did factoring the easy way and then solving equations by using factoring. Okay. So now we know how to do the factoring, and then we pick up where we had already done 9.4. Some number times some number equals 0. This is just could rewind the tape a few weeks. You hear me saying the same thing about 9.4. Some number times some number equals 0. I'm seeing this as 1, 2, numbers multiplied together give me 0. What did we say about one number times another number equals 0? What do you know?
One of them has to be 0.
One of those numbers
has
to be
0.
One or both. So, either this guy here is 0, or this guy 0. Either this first factor is 0 and 0 times that is 0, or this second factor is 0 and this left parentheses, whatever it is, times 0 is 0. And we solve for n now by subtracting 5 on both sides, 2n equals negative 5, divided by 2 on both sides, n equals negative 5 halves.
We just take them out of parentheses.
Yeah, just take them out. So let's say either this is 0 or this
yeah.
equals 0. To have this in parentheses is kind of unnecessary. I don't need to group it for any reason. So we subtract 3 on both sides, get 2n equals negative 3, divided by 2, n equals negative 3 halves. You can see kind of the big picture there, but of course, let's try it from beginning to end.
What is the goal of algebra?
From beginning to end. We can't quite start to solve this equation until we just take one little extra step. Because in the right side of this is a really important
minus
thing.
Minus 5.
Jason?
I found out that what's wrong with it.
What's wrong with it?
It's AB equals C. It's not AB and C again.
Right, so it's got to be A, let's say X. AX squared plus BX. Plus a C equals 0, and Ramy, we fix that by doing what?
Minus 5.
Minus 5 on both sides. We gotta get a 0 over here. So 7a squared plus 2a minus 5 equals 0. Now we can start. We can start solve this just like we did here. Factoring. Now factor times factor equals 0, and we set each factor equal to 0 and solve for a. Subtract 5 on both sides. So you got your notes out, right? No one
sure.
really have their notes out today. Did you work on that?
I've totally had it out all the time.
I'm going to come around and see. All right, to factor 7a squared plus 2a minus 5. I'm going to break out this x thing here.
Okay.
7 times negative 5 gives me negative 35, and I always write b here. Okay. What multiplies the negative 35 and adds to 2?
Oh,
five
7
seven.
Minus 5.
7 and a minus 5.
Yeah,
so we have 7a
five,
squared
bad.
Plus 7a minus 5a minus 5 equals 0. What do 7a squared and 7a have in common?
They got a's and 7's.
They got 7's and a's. So 7 and a.
That's what I thought he said too.
At least with a plus 1, 7a times a is 7a squared, 7a times 1 is 7a. What do negative 5a and negative 5 have in common?
5.
Negative
5,
that
means
a plus 1. A plus 1 times 7a minus 5 equals 0. Now I use the 0 product property that says either a plus 1 is 0 or 7a minus 5 is 0. A equals negative 1. Add 5 to both sides of this equation. Divide by 7. 5 sevenths is our second solution. We have a solution of negative 1 and a solution of 5 sevenths. Homework is right there.
What if you